Good morning and happy mining, everyone. I've got a rig that did not power on last night. This is a 14 by GA104 rig, and it's running on an ASUS B250 Mining Expert, that legendary motherboard. However, when I kick on the power like I normally do, the motherboard land lights turn on, but it does not power on its own. And when I hit the little jumpers for the power switch, it does power on, but it doesn't boot. So today I have grabbed a monitor from inside. We're hooking right into the HDMI in the motherboard, and I am going to get into the BIOS to re-enable power loss and mining mode. So hopefully that's all it takes, but let's see. Okay, so powered on, but we don't have a display out signal. I did remove the boot media just to make sure that it cannot do anything other than boot into the BIOS. But I still kind of wonder if we have other problems with this board here. Well, I've unplugged everything, I've reseated the RAM, and still nothing. So I wonder what our issue is. Hopefully the board itself isn't dead. I do have more of them, but... oh man, I don't know if I have time to deal with this right now, and I might have to come back tonight. Lame. This thing had been so reliable, but you never know out in the garage like this if there's like a rodent that's walked over it or something, or peed on it. I don't know. We'll come back to it. Bummer. Well, I'm not confident I'm going to be able to get all these back in the same order, but I am going to swap out the motherboard with another B250 Mining Expert that I have, so let me try to get this done. Oh joy. All right. Excellent. So far, so good. And that's what I like to see. Hopefully we get a bunch of green. Yep. All right, perfect. Hopefully we boot into Hive. Let's check. Okay, well, the problem child is inside, and thank goodness it's fine. But okay. I am running into issues with the boot drive, though, out there. It's a USB drive, which is not ideal. But I'm not sure how easy it'll be to find a SATA port, and these don't support mSATA or M.2. So what I think I'm going to do is just write a new USB, a brand new one, just to get a little bit more mileage out of it. So I'm glad to know that this board is okay. It's great news. Put the battery back in it, and yeah, let's go see what we can do outside here. I don't know what the hell is going on. All malfunction. I'm getting driver errors. I even went through and repositioned everything back so it was in order. I don't know what's going on, guys. I might have to drop this thing to a 12 card rig. I don't know. I have to imagine there's some issue with the riser or something. Well, after disconnecting all the GPUs again, booting it and still having issues, it looked like memory. So I grabbed a different memory DIMM. And so far, it's working. So I'm gonna run the driver updater. I'm gonna try mining on three GPUs. If three works, then I'm gonna go one by one, rebooting over and over and over again, and hopefully it was just memory? I don't know. Well, there we have 13. Looks like they're all mining just fine. I've narrowed it down to this port right here, which is GPU 13, which is actually 14. So I'm gonna shut it down and swap these two and see if that helps. All good. Let's see if we get them all mining. Okay. Well, that all worked just fine. So I think what I'm gonna do now is shut it back down, and then I'm also going to try to swap over to an SSD. All right, we can close the book on it. Everything is good. I've actually moved it over to the SSD now as well, and I've upgraded the drivers. So we're on 535, hold on. 535.113.01. I have not gone all the way to 545 with this, but anyway, I have no idea why the original motherboard cleared its own BIOS and then refused to boot, but the replacement board I had in the basement that I tested, it does post just fine, but I need to do more intricate testing in the future because this booted just fine, but anytime I ran commands with it, we had problems. And I've been having issues like that with that new Octominer as well, so I might rip out that little 4 gigabyte DIMM that was in there and just run the 8 gig. So anyway, I'm gonna shut all this extra troubleshooting junk off now, but this rig is good to go. Thanks for watching, guys.